Now, friends, we've come to our final study, and we've come to the very key verse of the epistle here in verse 13. Now, we have seen that John has made it very clear what it means to be saved, what it means to be a Christian. He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. In other words, it's the one that he's presented here, the one who came by water and blood, the one that was the Son of God, virgin born, God manifest in the flesh, died on the cross for our sins and rose again from the dead, and that is the gospel. And nothing else is the gospel, by the way. Now, verse 13, he says, "These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God." A twofold purpose, you see, that they might believe on the name of Son of God. That's salvation. And that you might know that you have eternal life. Now, if you have Christ, you have life. If you believed him, a great many people say, "I just want to believe that I have eternal life." The question is, who do you believe? Not what do you believe, but who do you believe? Do you believe God? Do you believe the record that he gave? He says, if you have the Son, you have life. Now, do you believe that? He didn't say, if you feel like it, or if you've joined something, but he says, if you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, and if you have him. And he says, that's the reason I've written this epistle to you, that you might know that you have eternal life. This is made, I think, very clear here, the purpose of his gospel. He says, many other signs truly did Jesus, which are not written in this book. That is the gospel of John. But these are written. John didn't write everything, just certain things. These are written that you might believe that Jesus is the Christ. That's who he is. And that believing, you might have life through his name. Now, if you have the Son, you have life. Now, he wants you to know that. And you honor God when you know it. And that simply means that you're not making God a liar. You're trusting him. It's not how much faith you got or how you feel about it. It's whether you've trusted Christ or not. That's all important.